This video is going to be about direct variation, and basically what's going to be involved is learning a general formula and the vocabulary that's used. The math itself is really nothing new for you. Okay, so the general formula for direct variation is y equals kx, and k is going to stand for a constant. The reason it's a k instead of a c is the Germans thought this up first, and the word for constant in German begins with a k. Now, when you have something like this, it's going to be read as y varies directly as x. So in other words, if you see a sentence that says y varies directly as x, you're going to write this formula, y equals kx. Another way they may say it is y is directly proportional to x. You know examples of direct variation. If I told you that, for instance, the distance that somebody drives is directly proportional to the time they drive, then this constant here, in other words, let's say they drive at 50 miles an hour, then the distance is going to equal 50 times the number of hours. So this is a direct variation. The constant is 50. And instead of a y, we're using a d here. And instead of a x, we're using a t here. And we could say that the distance varies directly as the time, or the distance is directly proportional to the time. Probably the best way to understand this is just to do a bunch of problems. So let's do some problems. Okay, so typically you're going to get problems that look something like this. If y varies directly as x, and y equals 24 when x equals 3, find y if x equals 5. So as soon as you see y varies directly as x, write the general formula, y equals kx. And now the next step is they're telling us that when y is 24, x is 3. So let's replace the y and the x with the numbers we're given. So we're going to have 24 equals k times 3. And I'm just going to rewrite that as 24 equals 3k, because that's a form we're all more used to. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to find k. So I'll just divide both sides by 3. 24 divided by 3 is 8. So k is equal to 8. Now I can rewrite my general formula with the specific value for k. So y equals 8x. Now I know you've seen equations like this before. And all they're asking is, they're saying find y if x equals 5. So we're going to replace the x with a 5. And y is going to equal 8 times 5, or 40. And that's all there is to it. So basically, you start with the words they give you. If they say y varies directly as x, or y is directly proportional to x, write your general formula. Then, if they give you the y, an example of y and x, substitute those in, plug them in for the y and the x in the general formula, and find out what the k is, the constant of variation. Once you've got this k, this constant of variation, then all you're going to do is rewrite the general formula as a specific formula and find the answer to the question they're asking you. They're saying, what is y when x is 5? So you'll plug 5 in for x and get your answer. Here's another problem. The amount of pay a worker earns is directly proportional to the number of hours she works. So if you think about this, this makes sense. If she earns $36 when she works 3 hours, how much will she earn if she works 7 hours? Okay, so it says the amount of pay a worker earns. So the pay is directly proportional to, that means we're going to have direct variation is directly proportional to the number of hours. So let's use an H for hours. So here's the general formula. If she earns $36 when she works 3 hours, so she earns, that's her pay, $36 when she works 3 hours, so we still have this constant of variation and she works 3 hours, then they want to know how much she's going to earn when she works 7 hours. So the first thing I have to do is find the K. So once again, I'll just divide by 3. 36 divided by 3 is 12. So K, the constant of variation, is going to be 12. So let's rewrite this general formula as something more specific. So the pay is equal to 12H. And we want to know how much she earns when she works 7 hours. So all I have to do is replace the H, the hours, with a 7. Then multiply 12 times 7, and 12 times 7 is 84. And I'll put in a dollar sign. So she earns $84. So this is basically the same as the previous problem. We've got something that's the same as a Y, the pay, is directly proportional to, or varies directly as, so now I know that we're dealing with direct variation, and what it varies with is the number of hours. So we just have our P equals KH, we plug in the numbers, find the K, and then plug in the number for the specific problem they're asking us. Now, here's one that looks a little bit more difficult, but it's really not. If y varies directly as x squared, and y equals 75 when x equals 5, find y if x equals 4. Okay, so y varies directly as something. So we've got direct variation. Y varies directly as, but it's not just an x, it's an x squared. So this is the only difference, is we've got an x squared. And when y is 75, x is 5. So I'm going to have k times 5 squared. Okay, well, let's square the 5. So 75 equals, and I'm going to switch these around and make it 25k. So let's find out what k is. Divide both sides by 25. And I'm going to get a 3. So k is 3. Okay, so y equals 3x squared, and we want to know what y is when x is 4. Okay, so y equals 3 times 4 squared, and 4 squared is 16, so it's 3 times 16, and 3 times 16 is 48. Okay, so the only difference in this was that we had x squared. They could say y varies directly as x squared, or y is directly proportional to x squared. But basically, you've still got this general formula. The only difference is that we're comparing y with x squared instead of just an x. So we put a square here. If it was x cubed, we'd put y equals kx to the third. You could even have y is directly proportional to the cube root of x. So y equals k times the cube root of x, or the square root of x. This would just be a square root. Okay, so that's really all there is to it. It's just a matter of plugging in values, finding your constant, and then going from there. Okay, that's it for this one. I'll see you next time.